Welcome back to the Resident Evil The Complete Story. We're currently at part 3 and in the middle of Resident Evil 2 and 3, so if you're just joining us, you've got some catching up to do. Let's go ahead and make the disclaimer rather quick today. During the disclaimer, I asked you guys to tell me what your scariest moment in the Resident Evil series were. I'm rather happy to know that I'm not the only one that was terrified of the dogs in the first game. Alright, the question of this time is simple. What is the stupidest thing you guys found in the Resident Evil series? For Zonical and I, it's what I like to call the Gumball Monsters. We were recording an improv comedy for Resident Evil 6 Jake campaign, and I came across one of the new creatures, and they looked like piles of bubblegum, so I dubbed them the Gumball Monsters. I should probably find out exactly what they were called, but by the time we get to Resident Evil 6, there's gonna be so many stupid monsters, it won't even matter. Disclaimer time! The purpose of the Complete Story series is to allow you to walk into a room and discuss your favorite games. To meet this end, we give you a shortened version of the major plot points in a game. We do avoid subplots and side plots to characters that don't pertain to the main overall storyline. So important characters and information that is interesting, but not important to the main plot, we do create bonus videos for, and you will find those at the end of the Resident Evil series. All information collected is from the general wikis, the Resident Evil wikis, and the projectumbrella.net. Let's not waste any more time. When we left off, we were following Jill Valentine in Resident Evil 3. She's currently unconscious in the clock tower. So while we wait to get back to her, we're gonna move to Claire Redfield and Leon Kennedy, who just arrived in Raccoon City, and we're gonna begin to follow them for Resident Evil 2. Claire and Leon just got separated and decide to meet up in the Raccoon City Police Department. While they're beginning their trek across the now overrun Raccoon City, Sergei is once again deploying things to try and clean up Umbrella's mess. He deploys 6 tyrants, one of which is sent in to get the G-Virus pendant from a young girl named Sherry Birkin, while the other 5 are sent in to annihilate the U.S. Army Special Forces. We're concerned with the one that was sent in for Sherry Birkin, though. Once they reach the police station, they discover that most of the police officers have either left or been killed, and that Chris left the city weeks ago. With no reason to stay there, they decide to find whatever survivors they can and get out of the city. On the way out, Claire runs into Sherry Birkin, the daughter of William Birkin, who has the last remaining sample of the G-Virus in a locket and who is on the run from G. If you forgot who G is, that's William Birkin transformed into a massive monster, but we just call him G. Leon runs into Ada Wong, who claims that she is looking for her boyfriend. As they progress through the city, they discover that Police Chief Irons is accepting bribes to cover up Umbrella's research. They also come across Sherry's mother, Annette, who obviously is also William Birkin's wife, and she explains that Sherry is on the run from G. She reveals that G is actually William Birkin, who injected himself to ensure that Umbrella wouldn't get away. But we already knew this, didn't we? Claire and Leon discover that the G-Virus embryo has been implanted in Sherry by the G-Monster. If they don't find a cure soon, she will die, and that is just unacceptable to them. They discover what is potentially a cure for Sherry, and settle to cure the girl. Claire, Leon, Ada, and Sherry all go deep into the Umbrella facility, the very same one that currently has 5 tyrants roaming around in it. Their goal is to try and find the materials to create a cure for Sherry, but they run into G again. Ada seems to be fatally wounded. And refusing to lose her to this, Leon goes deeper into the facility to try and find first aid supplies. Why we couldn't just spray her with a first aid spray, I'll never know. Leon runs into the now insane Annette. She reveals to Leon that Ada is actually a double agent after the G-Virus sampled in the locket, and she's not here for her boyfriend. As these big reveals are happening, one of the tyrants running around this facility shows up, and Annette is forced to flee. But Leon is stuck fighting this creature. Just when all hope seems lost, the now revealed double agent Ada shows up and seemingly sacrifices herself to kill the tyrant and save Leon. Will we ever know if she was truly a double agent, or if Annette was lying? That reveal will come much later. Claire manages to create the cure needed while Leon is dealing with all of this, and they meet back up afterwards and inject Sherry with the cure. Claire, Leon, and Sherry begin to flee the facility as the self-destruct mechanism has been activated. Boy, why does everything have a self-destruct mechanism in this series? But just behind them is the fully mutated G-Monster, who's become nothing more than flesh and teeth with no emotion left. He chases them, intent on ending this horrific night with more blood. But as we know, since there wouldn't be any more games following this, Leon, Claire, and Sherry all make it out of the facility just in time to get the G-Monster stuck in the explosion. Leon looks off into the sunset and decides this can't go on anymore. He vows to take down Umbrella however he can. Claire decides that she's gonna have to follow Chris because she still hasn't found him. Ada is implied to have survived, though we don't know for certain if she has at this point, nor her true intentions. And with that, we close the book on Resident Evil 2. Or do we? In a shocking turn of events, Hunk survived the attack from G at the beginning. He wakes up and vows to accomplish his mission. He looks at his hand and realizes he's holding the only vial of G-Virus left. He then begins his trek to the extraction point. He of course delivers the goods, and lives to fight another day. And with that, we actually close the book on Resident Evil 2. I'm not gonna count the fight that Tofu had to get out of there. I wish we could wrap everything up in a nice bow there, but didn't we forget someone? Oh yeah, Jill Valentine is currently infected with the T-Virus and is on top of the clock tower, unconscious. That's right, according to the timeline, she's been there the whole time. Carlos finds Jill unconscious and infected and decides he needs to try and save her. He secures her inside the building and sets off on his own personal mission. Carlos goes on an adventure of his own inside the Raccoon City Hospital, fighting off zombies and the Nemesis, but in the end, he manages to get the cure back to Jill. Jill and Carlos begin to try and flee the city once again. As they attempt to leave, they run into Nikolai again, and he reveals himself to be a part of the Umbrella Monitor Group. It was his job to recover the combat data and get it out of the city. Nikolai quickly ditches Jill and Carlos again, and Carlos informs Jill that since their extraction point was destroyed, they need to find another way out of the city before the US government just blows the whole mess up to try and contain this cover-up. Jill and Carlos continue to battle the Nemesis as it chases them out of the city, and as it goes on, it mutates further and further, and it seemingly kills off Nikolai at one point. They eventually end up destroying the Nemesis with a railgun, and then escape the city by helicopter. Nikolai turns out to be alive and escapes via helicopter, delivering the combat data to Umbrella. Another helicopter arrives and picks up Ada Wong, who has a fragment of the G-Virus. The helicopter sent to pick her up was sent by Albert Wesker. I guess she was a double agent after all. Sergei flees the city by helicopter, allowing him to retrieve his test subject. You know, I do find it odd that no one notices these helicopters all leaving around the same time, plus the other ones for things like the survivors of the university situation that doesn't need to be covered. From a news report, we find out that Raccoon City has been wiped off the map, with a death toll exceeding 100,000. Nothing remains from the start of this horror, but it doesn't even come close to ending here. Sherry was taken into protective custody by the DIA and asked about any remaining family. Leon is scouted by a US government intelligence agent after he attracted the attention of a secret military agency with how well he handled Raccoon City. In exchange for Sherry's safety, Leon agrees to work with the agency. It is during this time that he learns that Ada is alive and working for Wesker and his group. Claire begins to do research to find her brother. Meanwhile, on the Umbrella-owned Sheena Island, some of the residents begin to wonder what Umbrella's involvement in Raccoon City was. Upon hearing that it was connected to William Birkin, and that there is currently an out-of-control outbreak, they begin to become concerned that the same thing may happen to them. Leon also finds out about Sheena Island, and he sends his friend, Ark Thompson, off to investigate what's going on that tiny little island. Meanwhile, down in a South Pole Umbrella facility, a truck driver begins to gripe about the fact that he was denied his vacation by Alfred Ashford. Upon griping about the loss of his vacation, he remembers a story about a man who was locked up in the basement of the facility. The man locked in the basement is no man, but the creature that was once Alexander Ashford, changed into a beast by his children, Alfred and Alexia. We'll be coming back to this situation very soon. Art Thompson arrives on Sheena Island and begins to investigate things. He meets with the head of the facility, Vincent Goldman. Oswald Spencer has the African facility shut down at this time. He's trying to hide the location of the progenitor virus. Vincent Goldman leaks the T-virus on Sheena Island in an attempt to get revenge to everyone plotting against him. The virus goes crazy on the island, and it begins to look just like the Raccoon City situation. With that, the game Resident Evil Survivor begins. We're also going to begin discussing Resident Evil Code Veronica, but all of this is for next time. So where are your favorite characters? Leon and Claire are currently doing research to find Chris and more Umbrella facilities. Ada Wong has been established as a double agent working for Albert Wesker. As far as Wesker's location, we don't know that just yet. Spencer is beginning to cover up all information he can about the beginnings of this virus. Chris is in a European country and about to run into a bit of a problem. Jill has managed to escape Raccoon City and is currently just straight up resting. And with that, I'm off to write the next episode of this series. Don't forget to check out our other complete stories, Kingdom Hearts, Zelda, Metal Gear, and Bioshock. And also watch our improv comedies where we act out characters in Skyrim and Mass Effect. And if you truly enjoy our content, you might as well go check out our Let's Play channel. Right now, we're going through all of the Metal Gears, Dynasty Warriors, and probably some Kingdom Hearts very soon. Thank you, and have a good night, everyone. Or if you're watching this in the morning, have a good morning. Or if you're watching this in the middle of the afternoon, enjoy your lunch. That should cover all the bases.